Ice Trader Gang. Ice Trader Gang. All right. Let's stop being stupid for a little bit. Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning in to another video. After a somewhat disappointing loss yesterday to the Pittsburgh Penguins, the Devils come back, fly to Pittsburgh, beat the Pittsburgh Penguins in overtime by a score of 2-1 on Sunday afternoon. And man, there wasn't a lot that went on in this game, but it was a good one. I tried to watch a little bit of it. I had some other things that I had to do that were going on, but I did eventually like watch some of the first period, some of the second period, and all of overtime. But great game. I just want to start by saying, subtle flex on my part, if I don't mind. Yesterday, I made a recap video about how the Devils should take out Nikita Gusev, put in McLeod, move Maltsev to the wing, and what does Lindy Ruff do today? Oh yeah, he does exactly that. Takes out Gusev, puts McLeod in at center on the fourth line, moves Maltsev to the wing on Zacha's line, and they won the game. You know, just a little subtle flex, because why not? I'm right, gotta show it off. Yeah, so the first period was definitely the Devils' best period in this game, even though they let up the goal and didn't score, but I thought their best period was then. And it sucks because the first Penguins goal was somewhat fluky. It was nice at the same time, but it was kind of lucky. To be fair, it was just a nice passing play between the Crosby line with Gensel and Rust, and Gensel gets it to Crosby on the complete other side of the ice. Crosby literally got so lucky just beating Blackwood just by his skate, like nipped it a little bit, nipped the puck, and it went in. But actually, I didn't see this goal like as it happened, so I had to go to the replay, like on the highlights, the condensed game on NHL Network, NHL.com, and it turns out Crosby shot that. It hit the post, the near post, went off of Blackwood, and then into the net. It didn't go straight in. It went off of Blackwood and in. So, severely fluky, lucky goal from Crosby. That line's honestly killed the Devils. They have 5 goals and 5 assists for 10 points in the last 3 meetings between these two. So, I mean, Crosby really always kills the Devils, but now Gensel and Rust are just adding gasoline to the fire. So the Devils couldn't do anything in the first period, but they do get a goal like a couple minutes into the second period. The Zajac line, just a great shift, good 40-second shift. Started off with Sharon Govich getting a shot, Kokkonen in a couple attempts on a shot. Devils have heavy pressure. Devils bring heavy pressure. The Pens couldn't gain possession or get the puck out of the zone. Zajac gets a dump-in attempt from Vatanen. He gets it to Kokkonen, who considers shooting, cuts to the face-off dot near side, eventually decides, yeah, Vatanen's wide open, and Vatanen just rips a one-timer booming slap shot past Jerry. Top glove side for a one, tied the game. I gotta give him credit. Vatanen has been actually pretty good the last couple of games. I would like to see him on the power play a little more. He's been getting on the score sheet a little bit, decently high expected goals for. So I would like to see him maybe get some power play time. Why not? And then that's the scoring for the rest of regulation. Nothing really happens. Each team really kind of trades chances for the rest of the game. The Penguins had most of the chances in the third period, but Blackwood just stands on his head, keeps the game tied, and eventually leads us to overtime. So the Devils go into overtime, and the overtime winning goal was just a thing of absolute beauty. It all starts with Ty Smith keeping good possession of the puck, not deciding to shoot it, not deciding to pass it, making a smart decision, finding the right guy, the right opportunity to either get a shot or give it up to the next man. We're starting a cycle game, gets it to Zacha, and he eventually makes some nice stick handle moves, keeps the puck on his stick away from defenders, makes a pretty decent move. Brad is trailing with him in the top of the slot, gets it to Brad, notices that Jerry is over committing to the near side and wraps it around. Chef's kiss. And that's it. The Devils win the game 2-1 in overtime. Thing of beauty. Okay, so moving on to the game stats. this is honestly everything on the stat sheet that I'm about to say is clearly recipe for any win. You do all of these things, or at least most of these things, and you'll get the W. So the shots were very even, 36-35 in favor of Pittsburgh. The Devils won 52% of faceoffs. They lost most of the faceoffs yesterday, which really killed them in the possession game. The PK went 100%, killed both penalties, although the power play had some good looks here and there, but didn't do anything. They were 0-2. And this is crucial. These next two stats completely flip-flopped from yesterday. So the Devils had 24 hits today compared to yesterday. They had only 4. So the physicality definitely stepped it up. I know McLeod had a couple of hits. Gusev doesn't really play any physicality whatsoever. But he added a little bit of physicality to the lineup. And this is something that they cleaned up from yesterday. Awesome. Can't say enough how good it was. They had only 3 giveaways today compared to yesterday, 22. My man Bryce Salvador always says, gotta stop turning the puck over. 3 giveaways in the entire game. And they win the game. Weird. And the last advanced stat of the day, the Corsi stats were in favor of the Devils. The Devils had a total team Corsi of 47-44 in favor of Pittsburgh. So they led in all of the key stats of the game, and they got rewarded for it by winning the game. And now just a couple of players to note. I'm going to group these two together because they looked phenomenal, and you'll know why. It's Brat and Zacha. Man, I've been giving Zacha a load of crap ever since he was a Devil. Not since his first year, because he only played one game in 2015-16. He only played one game at the end of the season with Elias and all that. And we were like, oh, Elias, come back now. But ever since then, he hasn't really done anything. But now this season, he's leading the team in points. He's playing very consistently. I have to apologize to Pavel Zacha. He's been looking really good. And even just for Brad, he looks very dynamic, a lot more consistent than he was in years past. He just looks like a completely different player, not afraid to shoot the puck. His stick handling and skating ability really separates him from everybody else, and he's a 6th-round pick. What a steal that was. But yeah, they've hooked up a couple of times during this game, not just in overtime. I remember there was one play where Zacha made a nice seam pass to Brat for a one-timer that Jerry just barely got on the power play from a one-timer. So honestly, if they hook up more, I'd love it. And the last guy is obvious, completely obvious, and that's Mackenzie Blackwood. The Devils would not have won this game if it was out without him. It was kind of surprising. No one really knew when he was going to come back from injury. They said Amanda Steyn eventually said that he had a nagging injury that kept him out of yesterday, which, all right, fine. That's fine. I just want him to be better. But he came back for this game, lights out. Made 35 saves on 36 shots with a .972 save percentage and a .95 goals against average. His expected goals against was higher at 2.2, so they expected him to give up like 2-3 goals about. He had a perfect save percentage against high danger shots, 9 attempts, 9 saves. The goal against, like I said earlier, was kind of fluky, went off of the post and then him and then in. Nothing really you could do about that, and it's Crosby. And it's kind of a nice shot, I guess, lucky, whatever. And just not even looking at the advanced stats, he was making a ton of big saves, flashy glove saves. His rebound control was excellent. And like I said, he was the reason why the Devils won. Let's be honest. So I am very excited for the week coming up because the Devils play the Flyers on Tuesday and then back-to-back against the Capitals Thursday and Friday, all on the road. The Flyers game, I'm really excited about. They've been not good lately. Both goalies for them, Hart and Brian Elliott, have just looked garbage. Plus, my roommate's a Flyers fan, so I really want to give it to him so bad. It's good to see they're finally getting rewarded for good play, because over the last couple of weeks, we were like, they're dead in the water. They just are absolutely terrible. And just a flip of the switch, they're all of a sudden playing really well, getting a point in 4 of their last 5 games this week, and honestly should have gotten an overtime win against the Islanders. but I guess we won't talk about that. And their only loss was to Pittsburgh, and it wasn't really a great effort, but they came back. They bounced back today, played a completely better game, much better game, and they got rewarded for it. And it's a little late to say that they're going to push for a playoff spot, even though they're down a couple of games compared to other teams, but that two-week period where we just got one, two wins definitely killed us. But this is great to see. Everybody's producing, playing the way they should, and we should hope that they keep playing like this, even though we might not make a playoff spot, and even though they might not win a game. So with that said, that will do it for this video. Thank you if you decided to stay the whole time. Not only should you like and subscribe, but you should also comment for what you thought of the video, what you thought of the game, and other things you want to see going forward. Don't forget to check out the Twitter page at IceNJD, where I post live reactions to the games and any updates that Amanda Stein or any other Devils account has to offer. Tweets out, I'll let you know. So with that said, I will see you on Tuesday after the Flyers game. Definitely deserve it. Let's go Devils. Sean out.